While Russia was fighting Ukraine and the Middle East was in chaos, the European Union was tackling the really important issues, banning powerful household vacuum cleaners. EU bureaucrats made the heroic move in order to save the planet. Now, whenever Europeans vacuum with their weak vacuum cleaners, they'll be reminded of how European Union laws have taken over more and more of their lives. A former leader of the Czech Republic who grew up under communism came to Brussels and he gave a speech. And he told EU lawmakers that the European Union reminded him of the Soviet Union. And he was booed. Václav Klaus saw in Brussels a Soviet-style group of elites deciding what they thought was good for Europeans and then ramming it down their throats. But all of the new laws out of Brussels restricting vacuum cleaners or the size of fruit have not made Europeans freer or more prosperous. EU economic growth in the second quarter was zero, and economists say the third quarter is looking worse. Economic sanctions against Russia will rob Europe of key markets, and now even powerful EU member Germany is reported to be at risk of recession. In fact, the healthiest, most competitive economy in Europe is not even in the EU, it's Switzerland. So if the European Union isn't making Europeans freer or more prosperous, what's the point of it? Dutch filmmaker Peter Vlemmix asked himself a similar question and made a documentary entitled Euromania.
The European Union, its mission statement is to improve the life of the European citizens. But in my eyes, it's improving the life of some European politicians.
Vlemmix's film shows a corrupt, bloated bureaucracy that keeps growing and taking more and more sovereignty away from member nations, replacing 70% to 80% of national laws with EU laws.
Every law coming out of Brussels automatically overrules national law. So every day there is like laws coming and taking powers away from the countries.
Several years ago, when some European nations showed their disapproval of where the EU wanted to take them and voted down a proposed European constitution, the EU just went around voters and ratified one anyway. With its laws cranked out by an unelected European Commission and then forced on member nations, it certainly looks very undemocratic.
Those accusations are somewhat misplaced, but of course they make for nice sound bites.
Marco Inserti is with the Center for European Policy Studies in Brussels.
The European Union is not more undemocratic than other organizations, including national government. All of the surveys show that, in fact, the level of trust that European citizens have in the European Parliament is actually higher than the level of trust they have in their national parliaments, and it's way higher, for example, the level that the Americans have in the Congress.
But according to a Pew survey earlier this year, European support for the EU continues to fall. This was the opening of the European Parliament in July. While the EU anthem was played, several members stood with their backs turned. After disastrous May elections that led to historic gains by so-called Eurosceptic parties, like Britain's UK Independence Party, the European Parliament is now full of members who don't like the European Union and, in fact, want to destroy it.
I don't just want Britain to leave the European Union. I want Europe to leave the European Union. I don't believe that flag, that anthem, and that president, whose name no one knows, really represent what Europe should be.
Pro-EU parties are still in the majority for now, and the behemoth that is the European Union will continue to rumble on. But despite a quiet summer, all is not well within the European Union. With yet another economic crisis on the horizon, anger at Brussels could flare up again. The European Union may seem big and unsinkable, but it may also be headed for an iceberg. Dale Hurd, CBN News, Brussels.